I'm Leo Morris, editorial page editor for the News-Sentinel, and today we're talking to Tom Rotering, who's a Republican candidate for county council in the 3rd District. Tom, one of the things we're asking everybody, because the General Assembly approved a referendum for Allen County to potentially change the structure of government here, if that passes, it would go to one elected commissioner instead of 3, and the job you're seeking would be a little bit different. You'd have legislative as well as fiscal responsibility. What is your feelings about that? Would you rather serve on the council the way it's structured now, or the way it would be if that referendum passes?
I think if the referendum passes, it's going to give the people more representation, and I'm all for that. I don't know about the commissioner. I've never been a commissioner, so I'll let them speak to that portion. But certainly, if you can put more council seats in the county, I think each individual out there is going to be represented better. I mean, right now, you only have 4 council districts, which are quite large, because Allen County is big. And then you have 3 at large, which I'm not sure how responsive an at large person can be to the entire county. I mean, it's a big county. So I think if we break that down, and theoretically, you know, if you cut it into 9 sections, people are going to have, each individual council member is going to have fewer people to report to. And I think that's a good thing. As far as the legislative, I think that would work out better than having, right now it's 3 commissioners that are doing the legislating and the executive side. The council is basically just doing the budget.
Yeah, right now it doesn't matter much how many constituents you represent, because all you do is go to a commissioner and say, we want this, and you do it, and then we've got the money.
Well, I think that's the way it happens now, but I don't think that's the way it should be happening even now. You know, your representative on council should be the person that you go to. Just because you don't have the authority to change the law doesn't mean that you can't affect change, or you can't address that problem, whether it's maybe it's a road or it's a water problem, or as the council person, you should have those people in your Rolodex, so to speak, to be able to address that issue. You don't have to make a law in order to fill a pothole, but if you call and make that right connection, then you can get that constituents' problem addressed.
Are there other changes you would make in the way the council operates, or ways you would approach the job that you don't see it being approached now?
Well, you know, everybody has a different approach, and I'm not going to say the people there are doing it rightly or incorrectly. That's up to them and the people, whether they get elected or not. I think the way I would address it is I would use all of my contacts that I've had. Past 20 years, I've been very active in the party. I've been active in a lot of our sitting representatives' campaigns, so I have a working relationship with them. So I think what I would do is I would be more responsive to the needs of the people, because I have all the connections. All the connections, that's a bad word, but I certainly have a lot of connections, personal connections, that we can address issues without maybe taking them to a meeting or waiting on a monthly basis to address those needs. And, you know, I don't look at council as legislative. You're the representative for the people. And if the people have an issue, you're there to represent them, whether it's getting in your car and driving down to the state house during session, or whether it's driving to a different area, dealing with a different member of a different sector of government, that's your job. That's how I would approach it.
What would you bring to the council that your opponents don't?
I think just what I just talked about is what I'm going to bring. I've been active in the party, and not just saying active, I mean, it's my second term as a secretary of the party. Been a precinct committeeman for many years. I'm active and have been active since I was able to pound stakes into the ground in campaigns because I believe in getting the right people elected. So I don't just talk the talk, but I walk the walk, and I have been for many years. So I think that's where I'm going to stand out. And I'm not afraid to get dirty. If something needs to be addressed, then we need to address it. And I'm going to have the means to do that, whether it's with state representatives or state legislators or county, or the ability to communicate with the city, which I think we could do a better job of right now. And because of my job working with the city and my activity in city politics as well, I have a good relationship with the city council. So I'll be able to communicate with them. Not that they don't communicate now, but I think I'll be able to communicate more freely than we do now.
For those who don't know, what's your background? What private sector experience do you bring to the job?
Well, I have, in July, I will finish my 19th year in Fort Wayne Fire Department, the last 10 of which I've been a fire investigator. So that's for all those people. It says under investigation, that's me. So, and then I also, some of my off days, I work for a company out of Indianapolis that does private fire investigation. So we work for different attorneys. Sometimes we work for insurance companies. So I'll travel all over the region, really, Michigan, Ohio, Indiana, Illinois, and go there and investigate fires, which does give me an opportunity to see all these little burbs and the larger towns around and see what they're doing. But, you know, I bring the ability to investigate. I dig.
I never thought about that, but I guess looking for a fire.
Not unlike yourself. You want to find the truth. You want to find the answer, and you want to find out what happened. That's primarily what I do. So in my nature, I don't think that I'm going to change when it comes to.
Of course, if you're on the council, you might be looking for hidden assets in the department's budget. So.
I would hope that there are not any hidden assets in any of the department's budgets. If we do, we probably need to address a new department head.
Have you looked at the county's budget? Do you think are any imbalances? Are there any areas where we might be overspending and maybe where we might be underspending?
Well, I've looked at the budget, but without having a good baseline or a good understanding, you know, I'm not going to come in and say that I know everything about the budget. I've looked at the numbers, but that's kind of like you looking at the numbers. Or maybe you're very educated in what you're looking
at. No, I'm very enumerated.
But to just look at the numbers and not have an action, you know, I think that's something that I'm going to have to learn. I think anybody has to learn to sit down, go around, and communicate with the department heads and ask them, what is this line? And why is that so high? Or why is that so low? I'm not the person that just goes in there and wants to arbitrarily cut budgets. You know, if there's a need and a department head can articulate that need, then I'm certainly going to listen to them, and we might increase the budget. Now, obviously, we don't want to increase taxes unless it's absolutely necessary. I'm not a proponent of that. We're going to have to find some savings somewhere else, and hopefully we can do that through other departments. You know, I recently, with the snow, and probably I won't be the only person that would offer this complaint, but my street got plowed one time, about 4 days after it needed plowed. And we all know how many heavy snows we had.
Yeah.
So 4 days after it needed plowed is an issue. And sometimes I think a lot of the streets could use resurfacing a little sooner than they get resurfaced. Things like that, I think, is where we need to be looking to spend our money. Because if not that, where is my tax dollars going? And I don't think as a taxpayer or a citizen, you should have to ask that question. And if you do, I should be able to answer it.
generated. What do you think about the current mix of taxes and the rates? We have about the right mix, and the rates are about the right place.
You know, I can make something up and say yes or no. You know, it would probably sound good, but again, without getting in there and looking at it, I'm not going to know. I might be able to look at a number and say that looks pretty high, or that looks about right. But again, without knowing how each one of these departments work, I would just be speaking to something that would be inaccurate.
Anything you want to get on the record that I wasn't smart enough to ask you about?
I wouldn't say you're not smart enough. But just probably if you didn't answer, I probably should just be asking. I probably should just be quiet. I certainly want to be the representative for the Allen County 3rd District. I look forward to being responsive to the 3rd District and being able to address concerns and being available. I'm not talking down to any of my predecessors or the people that are on council. I'm sure they do the same thing, and that's what they want to do. But that's my priority in finding solutions to problems.
Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.